Howdy, folks, and welcome to episode 34, Sky Factory 2.5. A little glitch action over there. I've been messing with this mana spreader, mana pool. I made up some day blooms and some nightshade flowers. And if you right-click on them, you see it says unknown status, and you right-click on it. I don't know what exactly that does. I guess that's how much mana it's collecting. And you see to the right of that status bar, you've got the mana spreader icon with a check mark on it. I'm assuming that means that it's in range of this guy and it's feeding it. And then this guy's feeding right into the mana pool. So I just get my gunpowder. You see I've got the check mark on there. I can drop it in there. And I get the mana dust, or whatever it is. Let's see how many I can get. Can I get them all? Awesome, got them all. Plenty of mana in there. Now, what I found was that these do decay, apparently. The reason I have two different kinds of flowers out here, the day blooms and the nightshades, is based off their names, that's exactly what they do. The nightshades collect mana at night, and the day bloom collect mana during the day. This mana spreader collects it from the flowers and shoots it into the mana pool. It's pretty simple stuff, pretty easy. So what we were messing with before, we were trying to figure out how to make some of these runes or whatever. Let me come back in here. Okay, mana manipulation? No. It was the runic altar, wasn't it? Yes, this guy right here. Now, this guy has some recipes that we need. We've made the altar. Okay, so we need mana steel, mana powder, fishing rod, sugar cane, and bone meal. Okay. It also looks like it uses mana. Did you see that? Yeah, mana usage. Okay, so I need a mana spreader to feed this as well. I did not realize that. Okay, we're learning. So I need some mana steel. You see I've got two stacks of the mana powder. I've been at it for a little while. It takes a while to build up the mana that you need. I've already got the fishing rod in here. So just right clicking on that doesn't do anything. I think I have to drop these items. So, let me try that. We're just going to throw a queue out there. Oh, yep, there it is. It got caught by the runic altar. So, now just line up these other items down here so that I can drop them on it. And I think you only need one of each. So, we'll just queue, 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 and queue. Boom. Okay. It does not have enough mana to actually make it. So I need to make up another one of these mana spreaders. I don't even remember how to make it. I've got some more living rock, which is not what I need. I need the living wood, I think. Let me grab the rock too, and we'll grab mana pearl, because I'm not even sure what all we need. And let's come over here and see exactly what we need to make this. Let's see here. It is a mana spreader, right? Mana spread. Okay. Now, pulse mana spreader or mana spreader. I wonder what the difference is. And there's the Elven and the Gaia. See, this one is just a mana spreader with redstone. And then this one uses dreamwood, elementium ingot. Okay. And then, what the heck is that? Dragonstone? And that's the Gaia spirit that I need. Okay, so this is what we need. We need living wood and a petal. Can I make two of those? I wonder if that will help me out a little bit. Because it, and of course it's raining. Why wouldn't it be raining? You know what? We're going to go sleep real quick and get rid of this rain. All right. Just come up here. Okay. You know what? Let me up there. Good Lord. Okay. Come on now. Okay, not with a Botania item in your hand. All right, so let me come back down here. We're going to jump the gun. Okay, there we go. Now, I wanted to see if setting these guys, like if I place one right here and one right here, and then I put, because these are both, yeah, they're both facing towards this guy. Now, if I do that and that, right-clicking on them, that should have them working. Okay. Yeah. All right. And then I shift, right-click on that. Okay, it looks like both of these are trying to send mana into that. They just don't have any. So, we need to make some, we need to make some stuff. We need to make some flowers. We're going to need that. I think, no, is that right? Is it that one or this one? Oh, crap. I forgot. I know I need the orange. I think the light blue. Let me shift these over. Get the water bucket. All right, let's see here. I think it's the light blue. So we Q, and then one of those, and then one of those. Yep, that's it. All right, and then we throw that in there, and there we go. And just and miss horribly. Come on now. Give me back my torches. All right, there we go. Q, and Q. Alright. This is what I've been doing. It's easy enough. It's just repetitive. Time consuming. I don't know. I tried to connect this drum straight up into this thing. And I don't know what I was doing wrong, but it was not connecting to it, so I can't autofill this thing for some reason. At least not the way I was trying. I'm sure there's a way to do it, but I haven't found it, so. oh, crap, I put two of them in there. Okay, to get it out when you put one too many in, have an empty hand, shift, right-click. It'll take out the last one you put in. All right, and we'll do that, and then Q. Okay, we got eight of them. I hope that'll be enough for right now. I'm going to just kind of line these guys up right here. 5, 6, 7, and 8, and then I'll take that, and there we go. I don't know if this actually activates them or if they're automatically activated from the time you plant them. I don't know. But now these two mana spreaders are collecting mana from the flowers. And they should be sending it right into the runic altar. This is it. I mean, it's not incredibly exciting, to be honest. There's really not a whole lot you can do about it. Let's see here. I need the black, the gray, and the purple. All right, black, gray, and purple with a bucket of water is 2, 1, 1 nightshade. That's how I get the flowers that work at night. All right, let me throw that in there. Let's see, that was 2. There's the third one. And there's the fourth one. And you know what? I'm just going to go ahead and stop right there and plant these four. Let's see here. One, two, three, and four. Like I said, I don't know if this activates them or if they're active from the time they're planted. But now, whenever the sun goes down, I'll still be getting mana at night. Alright. Let's see here. Okay, look at that. I don't know how well you can see it. Let me try up here. Okay. You see, look right here in between where the two flowers are, okay? Boom. All right, you see that rune right there? How it has that greenish area? See it move just then? Okay, it's making it. It's working on it. Slowly but surely. So, we're going to go ahead and take these. Oh. Okay. Take all of them. Uh-oh. Okay. We'll plant you right there. And get the other one. Plant you right there. And these have different levels of mana inside them. That's why they're not stacking. How neat is that? Alright. Let me go and pick up these that I failed to pick up. And we're going to plant them right over here. 1, 2, and 3. Now, let me see if they're actually... Yes, they are registering the nearby mana spreaders. So they're in range. Excellent. Alright. Now let's check on this. Oh, it's halfway done with the first rune. Oh man, this is going to be a very time-consuming project. Okay. Hover to zoom out. Shift to... I don't care about that. But yeah, to make the rune... Okay, this is going to make 2 runes of water. And then it makes 2 runes each time until you start combining runes. And then you got to combine runes to make... like the spring, summer, autumn, winter. And then you got mana. Ooh. Wow. That uses a lot of ingots. what is this one? Okay, this is the 7 Deadly Sins, which uses air and summer. Wow, these things are expensive. It also uses mana diamonds. Rune of Gluttony. Also uses mana diamonds. Oh my god, these all use mana diamonds. Okay, while this is still working, I'm going to run over here and grab some diamonds real quick and see if we can't make some mana diamonds. I imagine we're not going to make very many of them. Let's grab a stack. And come back over here. So the reason I say we're not going to make very many of them is because there's not a whole lot of mana in here. I can make one. Yeah, one. That's it. Okay, so I've got one. Jeez, this is not cheap at all. Okay, I wasn't expecting that. But it's okay. It's okay. Let me throw all this stuff back in here. I've got so much crap in here. Okay. Throw those in there, throw the diamonds in there, throw all that in there. Okay, good. Now let's sort it. All right. I threw the extra book in here too. I got tired of carrying it around, taking up space. I think I'm going to throw these items in here just because they're in the way. Oh, I forgot to put the living wood in there. Oh, wrong one. This one. Here you go. Have a home. All right. Let's see what our progress is over here. Okay, it says complete. How do I get it? How do I take the item? Or is it still making it? You see the nifty effects. I mean, that's pretty cool looking. Okay, that's really cool looking. Okay, come on, what are you doing? I think it is making it. I don't know. Oh, wait. All right, so I need... if you look underneath the arrow with the check mark on it, that's Livingstone and this guy. So let me get some Livingstone real quick. I just need one piece, but I'll grab all of it because we can. All right, let me cue that. No, that didn't work. Do I need to use the wand on this? No? How does this work? What is this? I'm confused. Do I need to throw my wand at it? No? That's not doing it. Alright. Let me see if this says how I can retrieve the item. Let me come back here. Okay, the most basic and elementary rooms, four elements, sneaking and right-clicking. Move the last item. Attaching a comparator will do almost accepting mana. Okay, ready to craft a rune. But, okay, any runes used for recipes in the runic altar function as catalysts and will be given back upon completion of the rune recipe. Wait a minute. Okay, so I think I've got this. I think I need the alchemist, what's the thing called? Where is it? And this thing. I think that's what I need. Is that what is showing in the... No, that looks like living stone, not this. Because, yeah, it's not having any effect on that either. Okay, keep reading. Similarly to the petal apothecary, right-clicking this block with an empty hand after recipe is complete will place back the items used for the last... I didn't know I could do that. Okay, so with an empty hand, if I right-click it, it'll put the same items back in there so I can make it again. Okay. Any runes used for this recipe? Okay. But it doesn't tell me how to get the rune out of the altar. How do I get the rune out of the altar? Come on now. Okay, any runes used for recipe? Function as catalyst and will be given back upon completion. Okay, yeah, fine. Similarly, the petal apothecary, right-clicking this block with an empty hand, that doesn't give me back the rune. Okay. Drop a piece of living rock on top of it, or right-click with it. And use the wand on it again to... Okay, there it is. It should be apparent. Yeah, right. When the altar has received enough mana, when that happens, just drop a piece of living rock on top of it. Or right-click with it. Let me see here. I tried right-clicking with it, didn't I? Oh, there it goes. And then I use the wand. And... Oh! I got him. Okay, so then I need a empty hand. Oh, it did not give me back the items. I thought it gave you back the items. Okay. It does not give back the items. So, alright. We've got two runes of water. I need to go ahead and take a look at this and see what I need. I already forgot what I needed. I know it's for the end portal frames, but I can't remember what it is that I needed. And why did I come all the way over here for that? All right, end portal frame. I need Gaia Spirit. Okay, so I need to look in here and find what I need to make Gaia Spirit, which Is it? What is it? Mystical items. Is that what it's under? Oh my God, look at all this crap. Doesn't look like it's under that section. Bubbles in Ender artifacts. Whoa! Decorative end blocks. Ender observe overseer. Ooh, hand of Ender. Soul scribe. There's some interesting looking stuff in here. Okay. Alf. What? The portal to Alfheim. Holy crap! That looks like it'll be interesting. Miscellaneous. Let me see if there's a. No, there is no Gaia. I just typed in GA. What's here? That's the index. Ooh, maybe the index will explain things. No, Garden of Glass. What is this? Nobody can. Okay, no. So how do I make that? Is it under here? Oh, what is it called again? Oh crap, I'm hitting buttons too fast. Gaia Spirit. That's it. It doesn't, like I said, there's no clicking on it or anything. How do I get Gaia Spirit? Basics and mechanics does not have what I want, does it? No. So mana manipulation. There's the mana tablet, mana star. Huh. Manatide billows. There's some interesting stuff in here. Okay, what is this? Oh, this is these are the flowers that create the mana that those mana spreaders pick up. So a day bloom gets that. Rare flower patch, non-decaying flowers. That's what I want. How do I make that? It doesn't say. Among one travel, one might come across an unusual flower patch with flowers resembling day blooms and nightshades. Primus locus, a rare occurrence in the world where two special generating flora, the day bloom primus and the nightshade primus, can appear. These flowers act as, however, they produce mana a little bit faster and do not decay, making them great find. Oh, you can't craft them. You can't move them if you find them. Okay, never mind. All the rest of these decay, though. That one uses fuel. Whoa, explosions. Mana from food, mana from water, mana from leaves, slimes. From experience. What? Okay, and from lava. I've got lava. I might use that. but that's not what I'm looking for. That's the generating flora. Functional flora. You see, this is a little confusing, because I'm not seeing where the Gaia Spirit comes in, which is supposed to be something that I can get from this mod, but I'm not seeing it anywhere. Huh. This is interesting. Okay, well, that aside, I need to figure out how to get more mana going. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that. That is neat. What is going on here? Look at all these particle effects. I didn't have it over here. What are you doing? Whoa, it's full. So is that one. Which means these are. Oh, that's why I have particle effects. They're full. Okay. I get it now. I get it now. I need to make some more runes. What are some rune recipes? Mana manipulation. Wrong section. Wrong section. I need to go here. Runic altar. And where's my rune recipes? I made that one. I need stone, block of coal, and mushrooms. Do I even have mushrooms? I don't know. Oh boy, this might be interesting. Let's see here. Stone. Okay, we got that. And then block of coal. Oh, I do have some coal. And now mushrooms. Yay, stack of mushrooms. All right. Which means, I wonder how fast it'll go now that it's full. Because it was trickling before. But with it full now, I wonder. Let's see, I need this. And this, right? I think that's right. Let me move these up here. Set this guy down here, like so. Okay. Now, I should be able to just queue them on in there. Let's see here. Queue. Q, 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 Q. All right, it is doing something. Are you doing something? It has all five items. Are those the right items? Let me move that out of there. Put this guy back down here. Put this down here. There we go. Are these the right items? Yeah, stone, block of coal, mushroom. Mana powder. Oh, no, it's not. Oh, no, it's not. I need the powder. The powder. I messed up. I messed up. Okay. So with an empty hand, I can right-click that, and then I can cue that. There we go. Oh, crap. Look how fast it made that. Oh, and it already used up all the mana? Wow. Empty. They're all empty. Holy crap. I need to set up something better than this. Okay. Okay. We're getting there. We're getting there. We're learning. Man, that thing used a lot of mana really fast. And it's almost halfway done. Okay. This is neat. This is cool. I wonder if I can... Okay, this is empty. This wasn't empty before. So that means that this guy is actually reaching that one? Is that what that is saying? Oh, that is so cool. Tell me that is how that's working. Let's see here. Shift. Is it? I can't tell. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at this. Oh, what is happening here? Okay, no. You are going to focus on this guy right here. There we go. Okay, now that's focused on this. And this guy right here, I'm going to focus on this. Yeah! Oh, look at that. Okay, so if I take out this one, there we go. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Awesome, awesome, awesome. All right, let's try this again. Okay. Aiming towards this. Right here. There we go. Look at that. It's shooting the mana into that. So now I just replenish these flowers here, replace them, because these all died. Oh, all these died too. Wow, okay. These flowers don't last very long. I wonder how the lava flower would work. That would be interesting. I'm going to find out. I need to see how to make it. I'm excited now. This is getting fun. I need generating flora, and it was the thermalily, which uses, okay, I have to actually make a rune of fire and a rune of earth. Okay, I can't make that one yet. What about, what is this? Uses fuel, TNT, food, water. That one might be easy. That's how you set it up. Oh, two blue, two cyan, and one mana powder. Okay, so I get this out of the way. All this out of the way. Please, thank you. Okay, so I need... That's the light blue. I need regular blue. Where's the cyan? Right here, right? Okay. So, I throw in two of each and a mana powder. Oh, my bucket! Okay. So, we throw that in there. And then, Q, 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 Q. There it is. And, oh, I need the seeds. I need the seeds. Come here. And then, Q. Alright. We're getting there. We're getting there. Okay, I need to make three more of these. So, one, two, one, two, one, and one. Got it. Two more. Alright. One, two, one, two, one, and one. Alright. Bucket. One, two, one, two, one, and one. Alright. So, now I've got four of these. And... How did it show that again? It showed it... Okay. So that looks like just an infinite water source with slabs. Is that living wood slabs? I don't know. Or is it just regular slabs? I don't know. Shoot, we're going to do it. We're going to make this. We're going to make it. It's only going to take a second. I need... Two things. I need water, one, and two, and then I need some slabs, which I've got some dark oak slabs that will work. We'll take it. All right, get this out of the way. Get that down there. Get that up here. Get my flowers ready. All right. Now we get our slabs. Come back over to this guy. Alright, let's see here. I can do that, 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 and that, and that. And then I put that guy right there. Put that guy right there. Okay, I have an infinite water source. And now, one, two, three, and four. Whoa! Okay. It's working. Oh my god, it is working. Do you see the mana pulses that are coming out of this? Alright, let me turn the... check the status on all of them. Okay, they're all good. Oh, man, this is awesome. That is... Oh, the water system works great. That works a lot better than the daylight one. Because it's already done. Haha! Awesome. Awesome. Sorry, I'm a little excited because this is working better than I thought it would. Alright, so I... Right-click that on there, and then right-click that, and boom. I now have two runes of earth. Awesome. Okay, so what I'm going to do... oh, man, this is too cool. I need to make more of those. Those work really well. Okay, I need to figure out what the others are that I need to make. All right. Well, and... Then there's this. I need to put this back on the ground because I'm going to need it sooner or later. So I'm going to set it right here. That way I can take this guy. And if I shift right click and then shift right click here, boom, it shoots into here and it will fill this guy up. Oh man, look at how fast that thing is working. Oh, that is so cool. But there's no fill status on this. And I'm not sure what the tablet thing is there. Because that looks like the tablet icon there on the left. Alright, but it is continually shooting mana into the mana pool. So I'm going to let it keep doing that. I like that you can aim the mana spreaders. That is just too neat. But anyway, that's going to do it for today, folks. If you enjoyed the episode, please leave a like, subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Bye now.
Thank you.